Hi, Body Peak here. We bald right now because we're about to install a wig, okay? So I already started on the process. You know, I'm using a pantyhose. I like it better because it's like thinner and it comes in various colors, so I can easily use like a brown one that matches, you know, my skin better. Got this from my local beauty supply store. We're gonna be installing this blonde unit today. I'm excited. You guys know I haven't done like a full blonde unit before. Looks like I don't got hair, but you know, I got a little something on it. But yeah, we're gonna be installing a wig. This is in partnership with Kiss. I'm gonna be using their Kiss Almighty Bond Lace Front Wig Glue. There you go. If you're familiar with the Kiss Almighty Bond Lace Wig Glue, it's still the original formula, but they just have like a different bottle, a more convenient bottle, a dual tip bottle, so that your application process can be way more seamless, way less messy, way quicker. One side is the precision tip, so it allows you to easily place the glue wherever you want it. You know, gives you just enough. And let's say your wig is lifting, you can just easily go in, you know, put a little dot wherever it's lifting to stick it back down. And then the other side is a silicone tip. Allows you to be able to easily apply and spread the glue at the same time. So instead of like needing like an extra comb or like spatula or whatever, you can just easily spread the glue across your hairline. You can put as much or as little as you want. It's up to you. And it's silicone, so it's like gonna be easy to clean, and you're not gonna have like all this gunk of glue stuck onto it. That's convenient, you know, having that feature embedded in the bottle. Before I install the wig, I'm gonna go ahead and give you the rundown on how I achieved the color and the style, all the fun stuff. I'm going to be using this 613 unit from Peak Mill Official, and initially I didn't have a clear direction on, you know, the style that I wanted to do or what cut I wanted to do. So I just decided to keep it simple. I started off by simply layering, you know, light layers towards the ends to make the ends appear more full and layered rather than, you know, flat and all even length. So I'm gonna go ahead and tone the hair to the blonde that I actually want. I'm mixing Wella Frosty Ash and Pale Blonde, and I'm pretty much mixing them because I kind of want a balance between a warm and a cool tone. Like, I don't want it too warm, I don't want it too cool. I want like an in-between tone, because I think that's very flattering on brown skin. Mix that up with 20 Volume Developer from Wella as well, and then I just pretty much saturated the hair with it. All the money I'm spending, you're my heart desire. In this game, I'm a player. Cause of you, I retire. Yeah, yeah. Only you, you know, everything I don't. Cause of you, you know, At a point, I ran out of the mixture, and all I had was the Wella Pale Blonde left. So I just went ahead and mixed one more of that as well, and you know, applied it all over the hair, and luckily the tone still came out, you know, pretty much what I wanted. It didn't make it too warm because it's more of like a neutral tone anyway. All the money I'm spending, you're my heart desire. In this game, I'm a player. I let that process for 30 minutes, washed it off with the Shimmer Light shampoo, you know, just to keep more of like that neutral tone, and then followed up with the Ion After Color Sealer as well as the Intense Moisture Conditioner. In this game, I'm a player. So for styling, like I said, I didn't have a clear direction at the beginning, so I just pretty much blow dried it and straightened it. And I was actually feeling this look, but I just felt it looks basic, like it looks boring and flat. So I ended up adding like super big waves in it. 'Cause I go- everything for you. I initially wanted to wear it straight, but I decided it needed some body. I just felt like that's gonna do it more justice. So I ended up bumping it with a 2mm curler. It's not gonna be like super curled or anything like that because it's a short wig. It's just gonna be, it's gonna have some body, okay? Body, body. So I'm just gonna cut off the excess cap. I'm gonna try the unit on real quick to make sure I've cut off enough fabric. I'm just gonna cut off some of the lace so I can see things a little bit better. I'm liking the color so far. I think it's gonna be a beautiful color once I do my makeup. Cause you know, some of this color is looking trifling as hell with a bare face, okay? All right. I've cut most of the lace off to the best of my ability, okay? And y'all can see the tone of that lace definitely ain't it. Whenever I'm doing light colored wigs or I don't want to tamper with the root color, normally I don't tint it like the normal way that I tint, let's say like a black colored unit, because I don't want the color to stain. I want to keep the root as light as possible. You know, that's the look I'm going for. So in this case, I'm just gonna use some makeup to tint the lace so that it can match my skin better at the front. I'm mostly concerned about the front. I'm not even worried about the back because I'm gonna be doing like a flip over look. I don't even think I'm gonna put a parting. All right, we secure the cap. Now it's time to secure the wig. So I'm gonna be using the Kiss Almighty Bond wig glue. I'm gonna be using the silicone tip side, you know, because I really want to spread the glue across. And I'm kind of like applying it forward because it's gonna help keep the cap down as well so it doesn't start lifting. And one thing that I definitely noticed, it dries down fast, so that's good. And you just want to make sure you spread it thin as possible so you don't end up with like white gunky residue at the end. So I'm gonna add one more layer. So while that dries down, I'm just gonna go ahead and I've decided to use a powder, and it's slightly darker than my skin, but because the lace is so light, it's gonna all kind of balance out. I'm thinking I'm gonna add one last layer, but let me just try the wig on first. I'm gonna use the precision side, the silicone side, to spread it. This is easy, makes things less messy. Yeah. When I say let's go, undo it, undo it, undo it. I'm just gonna cut off some of this excess lace at the sides. Alright, so I'm gonna do my makeup really quick and we're gonna come back. This is actually looking good before even adding makeup. Like, I like this color already.
Y'all, don't make the same mistake that I did. Go easy on that powder, because once it gets on that hair, it's hard to get out, because you know, everything just sticks onto blonde hair. But anyway, I had to go in with a makeup wipe to, you know, try and remove more of that powder from the hair as much as possible. I didn't get it all out, and you know, I was a bit disappointed, but you know we're still gonna make it work. It also kind of messed up the style a little bit, but we're gonna be all right.
So this is me from the future. But yes, so whenever I go to bed or whenever I'm taking a shower, I always tie it down. Or whenever I'm like idle and I'm not, you know, I'm not needing to use my hair for anything. I just typically tie the lace down, you know, that kind of manages it for a very long period of time. Initially, I plan to keep the wig on for a week, for at least a week, because I use 3 layers and that's kind of like the average for me whenever I want to keep the wig on for up to a week in most cases. But I want to wash the wig and like refresh the style. I'm not very good at curling hair on my head. I have to, you know, take it off and style it on a mannequin. So I want to uninstall it, but before I do that, I wanted to test out like the waterproof capability. So I have a spray bottle right here. Take this off. And I'll definitely say the glue definitely has a very nice hold. I did have like some slippage here and there, but I just simply use the precision side of the glue to occasionally go in. Usually it's like, you know, areas like the tips, like at the edge right there, or like around the ear tabs, because once you take shower or whenever you because when you take shower or you wash your face or when you take off your makeup, like the soaps, the oils, the alcohols and stuff, sometimes they can get in there. And that's why it's always good to always tie it down so that the whole lace doesn't go lifting. As long as you tie it down, it's gonna stay in place. So I did have like those minor lifts here and there, but it's not like super major. But for the most part, you know, the wig is still on pretty strong and it's been just 4 days. So I'm definitely confident that it's gonna last up to a week or even more. And this is just I did three layers before placing the wig on, as you guys saw earlier in the video. So yeah, and like at this point, the glue is pretty much kind of like, it's in there. It says it's waterproof. So let's say you're going on vacation or you wanna go swimming or you even wanna wash the wig on your head, you know, spraying simply water on it or getting it wet shouldn't cause it to come off. Obviously, if you're washing the wig on your head, you have to be careful not to go too close to the lace at the front. Mainly kind of focus more on the hair so that the soap doesn't end up mixing with the glue and lifting it. And this is just water, there's nothing in it. But anyway, I just wanted you guys to see that spraying water on it doesn't cause it to fall off or anything like that. The sides are usually where you get the lifting. But if you tie it down, literally it's gonna glue itself back on. Or let's say you go to the gym, you work out, you sweat, just tie it down, because the glue residue is still gonna be underneath. It's still gonna be able to stick onto your head. It's definitely pretty strong. You can definitely go swimming in it. What else? No odor and no chemicals in it, no synthetic ingredients or anything like that. So it's definitely safe and it's definitely convenient. Like, you know, the dual tip thing, less messy during application. I really don't have much else to say. So uninstalling it is also pretty easy. They have this almighty remover. You can simply just apply it all over and you rub it in. I love the fact that it foams up. It kind of makes me feel like it's actually working. I kind of prefer this to like the ones that are typically greasy, like oil-like. This feels more like, you know, shampoo kind of. And I also prefer it to alcohol because alcohol can be quite drying. The glue removal process is definitely much quicker with this as well, I've noticed. And you just rub it in, you let it do its thing for like a few minutes, and then you just start. I don't even think I did that for a few minutes. That was literally like a few seconds. But you know, you just start lifting it and it comes off so easily. And I think the fact that I sprayed it with water prior to using the remover also helped. And you go right ahead and shampoo and condition your hair, and that's pretty much it. Okay. Anyway, Thank you all so much for watching. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful. I'm gonna leave all useful links in the info section below, and you can definitely find the Kiss Almighty Bond glue at your local beauty supply stores and on Amazon. And I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.